people might experience burnout because they might not be completing their stress cycles, essentially. That could mean if I felt stressed or annoyed about something, if I felt tired, you know, what might someone do who might experience burnout? Well, if I'm feeling tired, really, it's our body saying, hey, you need rest in one way or another. So to complete the stress cycle, it's to find some way to deal with that rest, right? That sense of needing rest, so we can recover and then get more energy to go about back into our lives to do whatever we need to do. When we experience burnout, that person instead might say, oh, I'm tired. Okay, well, I might have another cup of coffee, or I might, you know, take an upper or something like that, right? I might do something to get me to feel even more energized, because maybe I have certain beliefs or something that I need to keep on going. I need to be more productive versus listening to our own body and completing that stress cycle, which is listening to that the body needs rest in this case, and that I need to do something in terms of getting that rest. That could be sleep, but that literally could be resting our mind. It could be, you know, reframing the expectations that I have for myself for that day or for that year or for that hour. What is a stress cycle? A stress cycle is just basically, think about a story, how it has like a beginning, middle, or end to it, right? And if we want to finish the whole story, well, we need to kind of understand all the different, you know, steps or layers that go from beginning, middle to end. So whether that is, let's use example of I'm working on a project, I'm feeling really overwhelmed, or I might feel angry about something. So let's say a stress cycle could be having a specific type of emotion and listening to what our body, our brain is telling us when we have that emotional or physiological response in the form of an emotion. For example, let's say it could be anger, and what do we do with that? So it's finding healthy ways to cope and deal with that emotional experience that's happening in our brain and in our body. So if I'm feeling anger, to complete a stress cycle, well, that might mean what I need to do to deal with that energy, basically, that's happening when I'm feeling a sense of anger. For some people, it might be, I might go to the gym, I might, you know, do a boxing, you know, routine or something. But that is an example of how I might cope with an emotional experience that I'm having and kind of carrying it through to the end, so completing that stress cycle. Whereas for some people it might be, oh, I feel anger, for example. I'm going to find ways to minimize it, to shut it down, to ignore it. I'm just going to put it into this like pretty little box down there and I'll deal with it later. But what happens is when we start to increase our avoidant strategies of dealing with stressors, emotional responses, physiological responses are always telling us something's up and I need you to listen to that, then the accumulation of those unresolved, undealt with stressors, essentially, then can turn into the experiences of burnout. So burnout, again, is that experience of when I'm caring too much for too long, and I might have been avoiding things that I have needed for myself to recover, to feel more rested, or whatever it is that our body is saying that we are needing for us at that time.